My pranams to all Atma Jyotis, divine light of itself. Today is the auspicious day of Ananta Chaturdashi. This festival is celebrated as Ananta Padmanava Vrata. Let us contemplate the spiritual significance of Ananta Padmanava Vrata. Ananta means infinity, which is beginningless, endless. Anta means end. Ananta means beginningless, endless, is infinity. So Ananta Chaturdashi means, Chaturdashi means 14th day of the lunar month. Actually, Chaturdashi, in our ancestors, used the language and festivals and language and seasons and all very effectively to communicate some of the spiritual truths. Chaturdashi means, Dashi means direction. Okay? Chaturdashi means the direction of the 14. Five Jnanendriyas, five Karmendriyas, Manas, Buddhi, Ahankara, Chitta. So this is what we have. Five sense organs, five organs of action, and the mind. Mind consists of four functions. Manas, the attention, buddhi means intellect, ahankara means ego, and chitta means memory. So these together form the 14. These 14 are given a direction. Dashi means direction. Of what? Ananta. Infinity. These are finite. I am the limited individual, limited body-mind complex, which is limited individual. I am looking at the infinity, and that infinity is Ananta. So what is infinity? What is only Narayana Parabrahma is infinity. Narayanam Mahadneyam Vishwatmanam. He is the self of the universe. He is myself. My self, my Atma, that is Narayana. My Atma is infinity. What is the nature of Atma? Sat, Chit, Ananda. Ananda means bliss. Bliss is infinity. So when our mind goes towards the Atma Jnana, that is called Ananta Chaturdashi. So Narayana, the festival is celebrated as Ananta Padmanabha Vrata. Padmanabha. Padmanabha means one who has the lotus blooming from his stomach. Padmanabha is Narayana. Narayana is Ananta Shayana. What is myself? My inner self? My inner self, I, doesn't change at all. In my experience, there is a changing component of I and unchanging component of I. The changing component of I is called me, body, mind, intellect. Unchanging component of me, unchanging component is called I. So 10 years back, this I was like that. Today's I is like this. And day after tomorrow, I is like this. I never changes. The I is universal. That's why it's a... The I represents the universal consciousness or Narayana, which is myself, which is infinity, which is beyond time and space. That's why it's Ananta. So limited body, mind, intellect individual, which consists of 14, five organs of action, five organs of jnana, and five organs of sense organs, five organs of action, and mind, which consists of four actions, manas, buddhi, ahankara, chitta. They are directed towards the Ananta, infinity. That means Atma Jnana. So that is the festival of Ananta Chaturdashi. And on that day we worship Ananta Padmanabha. Padmanabha is Narayana. So Narayana is the consciousness resting. So it is represented, we do the idol of a Narayana resting on a snake, serpent, big serpent. The serpent is called Shesha. Shesha in Sanskrit means what is remaining. What remains? All of us perform certain action in life, karma. Once we perform action, the residue remains, vasanas remains, impressions remains. That impression is called Shesha. The collective impressions of the whole universe, of all living beings, together is called Shesha. Why Shesha is shown as represented as serpent? Because the ancestors represented vasanas, impressions as a serpent. Impressions rises like a serpent, otherwise it will be lying down. So for example, somebody has a desire, somebody is addicted to liquor. Until he sees liquor bottle, the desire is hidden. The moment he sees liquor bottle, it comes like a serpent, vasana. The serpent or the whole vasana of the entire universe is Shesha. And that Shesha, Narayana is sleeping. The I, the pure consciousness I is resting. And what is this I? My subjective I, the personal subjective I, which is not the body, mind or intellect, but pure consciousness called I. That is Narayana. Myself, my pure self, my inner self is Narayana. And there's a vasanas are there. My vasanas are there, individual vasana, and universal vasanas are there. These vasanas are like serpents. They're rising. Okay, Narayana is Padmanabha. Padmanabha means from his stomach, Brahmaji is born. This is a very graphical and pictorial way of representing the creation of the universe. Okay. So Brahmaji has four heads. The four heads represent four head represents Rigveda, Yajurveda, Rama, Samaveda, Atharvaveda. So Veda is in Sanskrit, it's called Shabda. Okay? The Shabda or the sound starts from the Nabi area, the stomach area. It starts as a para, a sound beyond silence, so a deepest sound vibration. Pashyanti, it becomes a vibration. Madhyami, Pashyanti means it becomes a image. Madhyami means it becomes a vibration in the throat. And Vaikari means through the mouth it comes as a sound. The word appears from the belly, nabi, rises into the chest, goes to the throat and comes through the mouth. So which means the subtlest form of sound is called para. Slightly grosser form is Pashyanti, slightly grosser form is called Madhyami, and the grossest form is called Vaikari. The sound manifests in the Nabi area, that's why the Narayana, is Brahmaji is shown to be emanating from the Nabi of Vishnu. That means Brahmaji is a representation of Shabda or Veda, that's why he is Chaturmukha. Okay. So the deepest sound is called Para. Para means a vibration. Pashyanti means it becomes an image. For example, somebody, I want to speak something now. First, there is the feeling of speaking comes. It's called para. Then, what I want to speak, some image is there, some vague image. Then it comes to para, pashyanti, madhyami. Madhyami means it comes to throat, where vibration starts. Then vaikari, it becomes a sound. So, this like that sound comes in four stages. Para, pashyanti, madhyami, vaikari. And origination of sound is in the nabi area. These musicians know very well. The sound is created from the belly button. So Narayana is shown as Brahmaji is emanating from Narayana, which is actually Brahmaji represents the Shabda Veda, which is four Vedas. That's why he has four faces. Okay. And what is the relationship between the Veda, sound and the world? Shabda, world, is nothing but verb. World. World is nothing but world. World is world. How is the world is world? A world has an image associated with that. If I say a flower, flower is a sound and flower is an image. Okay? Everything in the world is a name and sound. So, Shabda, Vedas represent the name and sound. The Vedas represent Brahmaji and Brahmaji represents creation. Brahmaji represents the universe. So, this emanated from the Nabi of Vishnu, which means in the form of sound, primordial sound, Omkara, which became four Vedas. So today is the day we remember or we offer our prana worship to Narayana, who is Parabrahma, who is my inner self and who is the Vishwatma, the self of the universe. That means I dedicate myself to Atmadnana. So it's called Chaturdashi because the Chaturdashi is 14th day in the festival season. 14 represents 5 organs of action, 5 organs of senses, and manasu, buddhi, ahankara, chitta, the 4 aspects of the mind, together 14. Dashi means direction. All these have to be given the direction of Narayana. Through self-enquiry, atma-vichara, you direct, dedicate yourself to self-realization, to realize the infinity in yourself. That is the festival called Ananta Chaturdashi. It's called Ananta Padmanabha Vrata. Any questions?